r/credit by Rob Attainment. What are some declassified government documents that are surprisingly terrifying? Project Sunshine, where the US government bought remains of dead infants to test for radiation. When they took limbs from them, the parents were never told. One mother wasn't allowed to dress her daughter for her funeral because doctors had removed her legs and didn't want her to find out. Is anyone else ridiculously disturbed that they named that Project Sunshine? What the fuck? Jeffrey Dahmer's full confession, a couple of hundred pages of pure madness. Necrophilia, dismemberment, skinning, lobotomy, body part preservation, cannibalism. Dahmer became pretty close to his interrogating detectives Dennis Murphy and Patrick Kennedy, and provided a lot of detail to them. A lot of it in a pretty candid, offhand manner. Operation Midnight Climax. The government hired sex workers to dose Johns with LSD for research purposes, so to speak. Endpoint Wikipedia.org link. Midnight Climax sounds like a porno. Threat level midnight. CIA involvement in starting the Guatemalan Civil War, which lasted 36 years and led to the genocide of hundreds of thousands of indigenous people. www.cia.gov link. Hoopsie daisy. And set up the country for the shitshow that is Guatemala today. Just like Nicaragua, Guatemala is a beautiful country and the people are also beautiful, but, as one taxi driver said to me, 25 families own everything in the country. Corruption is rife and the destabilization caused by the involvement of the US has been devastating for the country and its people. I watched from my hotel balcony as people came to the lake to bathe and wash their clothes. One US bomber accidentally dropped a nuclear bomb a short distance from a major US city, can't remember which, but luckily it didn't detonate. Off the coast of Georgia. They still haven't found it. My hometown was littered with radioactive waste by the federal government as part of the Manhattan Project. www.nighttimes.com link. Then we wonder why cancer and thyroid conditions are rare the norm. I grew up 2 miles from the Lua Lake Ontario Ordnance Works site, and my dad grew up on 89th Street in Niagara Falls in the 40s. He says that he remembers sitting on the train tracks as a kid watching the Hooker chemical trucks bringing 55-gal drums to the Love Canal. That whole area was contaminated with all sorts of nasty stuff. So what did they do? They bulldozed it over and built houses on it, of course. Then in the 70s, when people were noticing toxic sludge in their basements, kids' feet were being literally burned by the high levels of phosphorus in the ground, and people were getting sick. They acted like they knew nothing. Eventually people sued, and the whole area was evacuated. They tried to clean it up, but they basically put tons of dirt and clay over the area as a cap, and it's all fenced off. You can see it when you drive east on the Niagara Falls Expressway to Towander. For the Lewiston Storage Site, also known as the NFSS Niagara Falls Storage Site, I've read documents where they had hazardous storage barrels sitting exposed to the element, with seepage and all that. Again, they've covered everything with clay to stop it, but it's already in the ground. The bad thing is that there's a large elementary and high school Lewiston Porter about 2 miles from the site, which is actually on property that used to be part of the site, but was never used, and was sold to the county. Needless to say, the cancer rate among long-term staff and teachers is higher than average. I'm glad to have finally moved away. There are over 50 mishaps with nuclear weapons by the US Air Force in the 1950s alone. In East Germany, a committed freedom fighter and her husband had dealt with having her home raided while she was away, being arrested on the way to protests and all sorts of state-sponsored harassment. After the wall fell, she was able to read the documents the Stasi had kept on her and found out her own husband was an undercover agent and had written many reports on her activities with a bloodless banality. Suspiciously, she always has a headache when I propose having sex. Possible capitalist plot. British Metropolitan Police Services have done exactly the same on ecological protesters from organizations like Greenpeace. There was literally a case a few years back, like 5 years ago, an undercover cop I believe married and even had kids with a protester he was investigating the whole way through. The Department of Health and Human Services practiced female sterilization on Native American women all the way through the 1970s. Kinda sobering knowing that we were using tax dollars to suppress indigenous birth rates less than 50 years ago. n.m wikipedia.org link. This was so prevalent that between 25-50% of native women were sterilized against their will, and their birth rate dropped by 3/4 following this time. Black and poor women too. I remember reading a story about a 12-year-old black girl in the South in the 60s going to the doctor for an appendectomy and leaving sterilized without being told. Many didn't find out for years until they realized they should've gotten their period by now or were having trouble conceiving. cbhd.org link. n.m wikipedia.org link. Operation Northwoods, a plan for a false flag operation that came from the Joint Chiefs of Staff and Department of Defense in 1962 and given to JFK, who turned it down. The plan called for the CIA to commit terrorist actions against US civilians across the United States and frame Cuba, allowing us the right to invade and depose Castro and the communist government there. It was declassified and can be found online at the JFK Library. Terrifying that no one knows or seems to care that this was suggested by our government to the president. My high school English teacher mandated that I read this. I didn't understand it at the time, but he was responding to my question I posed him. As an airborne vet, why do you seem so jaded in regards to US history and politics? Still one of my favorite teachers to this day. He and I were able to go into all the other ost things the US has done. CIA invested millions in trying to make cat spies. $20 million to be precise. Know why it didn't work? Test hashtag 1. Their very first spookhead ever ran into the street and was hit by a car. They decided to not continue. When the space shuttle Challenger was destroyed, it was reported that all 7 astronauts were killed instantly. It was revealed decades later that some, if not all of the astronauts survived the initial explosion, as the cockpit cabin had enough protection to not be breached. For 2 minutes and 45 seconds, they were awake and aware as they plummeted toward the Atlantic Ocean. Understandably, NASA knew that the news of their terrifying death would have crippled the space program even more than it already was. We looked at this in flight school, and pretty much there's evidence to support that the crew was still running their procedures. Even after it was obvious shit hit the fan, they didn't die accepting their fate. They died astronauts. That's something to be admired in my opinion. My previous answer to another post. www.theblackvault.com link. Not sure if this has been mentioned or not. I'm not scrolling through a million replies. The site is run by a guy named John Greenhalgh. u/blackvault. www.reddit.com link. Started putting in FOIA requests when he was 15 and never stopped. Currently has what is arguably the largest privately owned collection of declassified information from the US government anywhere, and the entire archive is accessible for free. Not a direct answer to your question, but anything you want to know about stuff the US government was up to can be found buried in there, and he's taken the time to sort some of the more interesting stuff out to make browsing easier. Cheers. His Black Vault podcast is always a good listen, even if you don't buy into the UFO stuff. He doesn't hesitate to point out the bullshit from anyone, whether they are believers in this stuff or not, and gives a lot of time to skeptics to put their side of the argument, and treats everyone with respect. As a part of the Army and CIA's experiments into mind control, they put electrodes into the pleasure centers of dogs' brains. Initially, they wanted hundreds of dogs. They only actually got 10, and of those only a few were implanted. The ones which were would be remote controlled by zapping them and essentially giving them a dose of dopamine when they were facing the right direction. The controllers would stop the dope zap when they wanted the dogs to stop, and then the dogs would reorient themselves until they were facing the correct direction. This meant when the controllers weren't present, the dogs who had been implanted would continually spin in circles, even in their cages, always looking for the direction that gave them that next hit. The program ran out of funding in the mid-60s, and the dogs were destroyed. If you want to read all about it, and other things that the US and governments around the world are up to from the horse's mouth, I highly recommend TheBlackVault.com. www.TheBlackVault.com link. The website of /u/blackvault. Here's 100-ish pages of what I described above, helpfully FOIA'd and archived thanks to his hard work. Documents 2. TheBlackVault.com link. Edit for some bright side, via the same source we get remote control of War Dog's remotely controlled scout dog, June 1974, wherein we learn that we can just train dogs. They respond to audio and visual cues, and can be trained to turn on command at long distances, by playing a tone over the radio. Documents 2.theblackvault.com link. The dogs were destroyed. New Zealand's UFO files, NatLibPrimer.hosted.xlibrisgrub.com link are a bit creepy. I was in the library, and stumbled across the bound files. There's a lot of assumed crazy people being crazy, but there's also one specific one, that stood out from respectable Air Force pilots who were both in the air, conducted many tests, for instance blinking, moving the plane in relation to the object, verifying what he saw with the co-pilot though ensure it wasn't an illusion or his mind. I don't know, just the fact that you'd assume he wasn't crazy creeps me out so much. NZ is not real. Mkultra. Partially illegal, forced mind control experiments utilizing psychoactive drugs, conducted by the CIA in 1950s/60s. More specifically, the death of Frank Olson. Olson was going to expose Project Mkultra. Olson was a CIA employee who was dosed with LSD by his supervisor, and then committed suicide 9 days later, by jumping out of his hotel window. After an autopsy, there was some evidence found, that he was unconscious, when he plunged out of the window. N.mwikipedia.org link. Project Pluto. Fun for the whole family. Jalopnik.com link. The Nixon administration had a speech prepared for if the moon landing had failed, and it's chilling. You can read it here. www.archives.gov link. Really is chilling. Imagine if they landed on the moon and were unable to lift off again, just having to sit there and stare at Earth as they die. Yikes. This website contains a lot of them. CIA. www.muckrock.com link. www.muckrock.com link. Jeffrey Epstein. www.muckrock.com link. FBI. www.muckrock.com link. www.muckrock.com link. There's a lot more as well. The person who redacted those Epstein docs did a shit job. I just read through almost all of them, and in one paragraph the miner's name or initials would be blacked out, but it would be visible in the next paragraph. That is some sloppy carelessness when you're redacting a document involving miners. Don't they, at the very least, have a way to digitally block these names and then CTRLF back through it to make sure nothing is visible? I would imagine there is software for this specific purpose. Surprise, no one has mentioned the Panama Papers. They've been out for a while, but there's been little coverage of them. TLDR of them, lots of money laundering that was tracked pointed to major governments and global businesses, and hashtag X200B. Edit. Amazon Prime has a series called The Giant Beast that is the global economy. They talk about the Panama Papers in a couple episodes. Also Paradise Papers, the elite of this world money laundering, and essentially hoarding wealth. I wonder why the media coverage was super slim HMM. Oh come on, a lot has come from that. For example, the reporter that released them was assassinated in a car bombing. Not declassified but leaked. Operation Yellowhammer. The government tried to say it was old, but it had an August date on it. Dude, Mew English is nowhere good enough to comprehend the wiki article. Could you please summarize? Fun fact, Yellowhammer is an anagram of Orwell Mayhem. And now you said it here. They're coming for you. Run. We are planning to cut all homeless people in half in 2025, the UK government. That's the best example of bad wording I have ever seen. Boeing X-37B unmanned space shuttle. It just spent 720 days in space doing God knows what. Testing stuff. And maybe taking pictures like the one Trump tweeted of the Iranian space launch site. Edit. Apparently the USAF has disclosed that it's testing a heat pipe assembly, but I'm sure there's other stuff we're not allowed to know about. Can't remember the source, but apparently there is a legit order signed by Hilter to his nuclear researchers saying, if they have a viable nuclear explosive, start loading into V2s immediately. However, Germans didn't come that close to making a nuclear bomb. They didn't consider it a priority, because they calculated that it wouldn't be a decisive weapon to win the war, especially against US. who would already have nuclear bombs in their arsenal. Estimates put the probable year for a German nuke, if the efforts continued, around 1947. Good thing the Nazis were incapable of making a nuke. Thanks, Jewish physics. Here's one from the Brits and the Aussies in the 50s. Nuclear tests in Meralinga. Oh yeah, some aboriginals lived nearby. Australian map.net link. COINTELPRO, endpoint wikipedia.org link. Really sickening how the FBI took down the civil rights movement, framed, blackmailed and even killed various leaders. And people still view the Black Panthers as some sort of boogeyman. They were literally fighting for school lunches for kids. The Black Panthers were extremely effective community organizers, and the federal government could not deal with that. One of the most effective smear campaigns in the modern American history. One that is not US. There was an episode of Radiolab that talks about an enormous secret facility in Britain that houses the British Empire's secret archives. The way they describe it, it sounds like the place where the Ark of the Covenant is stored at the end of Raiders of the Lost Ark. What they uncover in the episode is the human rights atrocities that were committed by British troops during the MAU-MAU uprising in Kenya during the 1950s. There were details in the uncovered documents about detention camps and torture that occurred during the conflict. It gave grounds for surviving MAU-MAU to seek compensation against the Crown in recent years. The atrocities of the conflict were not widely known about until recently. www.onyxstudios.org link. There was an episode of Radiolab that talks about an enormous secret facility in Britain that houses the British Empire's secret archives. The way they describe it, it sounds like the place where the Ark of the Covenant is stored at the end of Raiders of the Lost Ark and hashtag X200B. So basically a giant warehouse and hashtag X200B. What amused me when I just looked into this is that they are using meters to describe how many files they have. 100.81 meters of files on the United States, for instance, and hashtag X200B. You know you've got a lot of shit when they can't give you a file count and just resort to saying how long the files would be if you lined them up together. The MKUltra mind control experiments. The CIA basically tested various means of mind/suggestibility control through many front organizations. The main intent was to improve interrogation methods, but later expanded into other avenues of research such as making sleeper agents. Tests were performed both with and without knowledge or permission on large numbers or American and Canadian citizens. While some files have been declassified or leaked, the bulk of the files have either been destroyed or remain classified. As a result, larger statistics on the project, such as death tolls, numbers of subjects and personnel involved, and research gained, can only be estimated as of today. The more I learn about the CIA, the more I hate them. It was also just super illegal, violating the Nuremberg codes. They drugged CIA members at random with LSD. They set up brothels to trap CIA agents into taking LSD, and then interrogated them. There was no informed consent. One person on LSD jumped out of a window, but his family upholds that he released info when on LSD that could be dangerous to the US, so the government killed him. This is just from the Wikipedia page too. Not really terrifying but fucked up, Operation Paperclip. Where after WW2 the US government took Nazi scientists and shipped them to America to do science. Some of them came straight from Nuremberg cells. The most noteworthy being Wernher von Braun. Von Braun built the V-2 rockets with Jewish slave labor. Every day they would execute the 5 slowest workers in front of the other workers to incentive them to work harder. Once he came to America, we shipped him to Huntsville, Alabama, where he built the Saturn V, the rocket used in the Apollo program, and got us to the moon. I always thought it was insane that Wernher von Braun was born within a decade of the Wright brothers' first flight, then sent men to the moon on a rocket in his 50s. I remember something about a heart attack gun I read some time ago. Basically a poison gun that once shot isn't traceable in the victim's body and leaves no mark on their body. Sry, if it sounds a rel y vague. Yao 2.b link, just watched it a few hours ago. Summary, a poison dart gun that is almost impossible to feel when it hits you. Upon entering your body, it injects you with a poison that causes you to have a heart attack and disintegrates, leaving behind only a small red dot, causing autopsy to determine that you had a heart attack of natural causes, which makes it a perfect assassination weapon. The US government did a few different messed up experiments with radioactive materials on people without their knowledge to see the long-term effects. Like what Jormungandr 315, oh, just feeding radioactive material to mentally disabled children and enlisting doctors to administer radioactive iron to impoverished pregnant women. Wikipedia link, n.m wikipedia.org link. Right now there's a radioactive pile of trash in St. Louis and the surrounding rivers which got infected with all the rain washing away the radioactive trash into the rivers, gave cancer to many people since the 1950s. The Panama Papers terrify me, and they are not even classified. www.isage.org link. Operation Northwoods. This is one that everyone should know about. Many elected leaders would have no problem murdering their constituents and their families if it suited their political agenda. Operation Mockingbird, Operation Northwoods, Operation Paperclip, the fact that we pardoned Unit 731. The list goes on and on. Unit 731 makes Mengele look like a pediatrician with good bedside manner. Read the book, One Second After. It's about what happens after an EMP attack on the US. It's based on actual government studies and estimates. It is terrifying. Their reasoning for Vietnam. Such a devastating waste of lives on both sides. See the Vietnam War documentary by Ken Burns. In 1972, a crack commando unit was sent to prison by a military court for a crime they didn't commit. These men promptly escaped from a maximum security stockade to the Los Angeles Underground. Today, still wanted by the government, they survive as soldiers of fortune. If you have a problem, if no one else can help, and if you can find them, maybe you can hire them. Does this kind of thing from an old, ask me anything counts, link 1, old.reddit.com link, link 2, old.reddit.com link, link 3, old.reddit.com link. That they actually did follow John Lennon around, and Nixon had a very strange obsession. The documents are quite surreal to read. What frightens me, just as much as how many of you guys in this thread know all the stuff. How did you hear about it? Where did you read it? How much is true? How much is a misdirection for other things? How was it covered up? Check out the Stuff They Don't Want You to Know podcast. They cover all sorts of things. They do a good job of presenting the known facts and then diving in the rumors and theories. They also do a great job of describing the difference between conspiracy theory and conspiracy fact. The Gateway Project, www.cia.gov link. Army intelligence is look into the feasibility of remote viewing and astral projection for military use, and, obviously, whether it even exists. Take it with however much salt you want, but clearly the group tasked with the report thought it credible, and the Army apparently did train a Gateway Task Force for intelligence. Operation Acoustic Kitty was pretty terrifying. Not terrifying because of its purpose, but because have you ever tried to make a cat go where you want it to? The CIA assassinated the democratically elected leader of Chile, Salvador Allende, in a $3 million campaign to topple its government in support of a ruthless dictator. I think this was declassified in the 90s. The complete fucking madness that was Chernobyl, the only man who survived being in the power plant had to have every bit of skin replaced. He can't touch gasoline. People basically melting from the inside. Concrete walls turned to liquid. People vaporized in the initial explosion. Firefighters falling to their knees and vomiting their literal guts up. Complete madness. I remember Noam Chomsky revealing a memo indicating that the US had blocked American Mennonites from sending pencils to Cambodian schoolchildren after the Vietnam War. Now, I know that's not outright terrifying, but the mince that it takes to make that decision, a worldview and way of thinking about humans, that comes from a cold, dark place. The US military has a directive in the case of a zombie apocalypse. In it states that every person, no matter what nationality or how their stance was to the US before the apocalypse, should be treated equal. Does it take a fucking zombie apocalypse for the military to realize that everyone should be treated equal? I don't remember the exact name, but there was a US government project to create individual profiles of all people detailing all aspects of their lives, but it was scrapped in 2006, the year Facebook opened to the public. One nobody seems to have mentioned yet, Operation Mockingbird. Endpoint Wikipedia.org link. With all of these terrible atrocities committed by governments in the past that have links and proof, it leads me to one question. What the hell are they doing to US right now? Project Pluto. If we ever used it, it would pretty much end life as we know it. It would have been capable of irradiating large areas of the globe within hours. All of the SCP files. I'm joking, though it would be terrifying if at least some of it was somehow real. Remember that huge candlelight protest in Korea back in 2016? Well, the military wanted to end it the hard way. MN.INA.CO.KR-Link. Not really declassified, but leaked. Room 641A. It was a room in an AT&T exchange with a whole bunch of monitoring equipment for the US government. Completely legal under the Patriot Act. The US government intentionally wiped out bison to the brink of extinction in order to disrupt the main food source of indigenous people who relied on them. They used this to force these people to accept terrible land deals or move them away. When they performed a lobotomy on Rosemary Kennedy due to her being intellectually disabled, at 23 years of age her father arranged a prefrontal lobotomy. At the time the procedure had only been done about 100 times in US, it failed, leaving her unable to speak intelligibly and incapacitated. She was conscious during the operation. They say that the neurosurgeons, or whatever they are called, ask the patient to count from 10 to know when they should stop cutting down. I've heard that they stopped when her speech was incoherent. Saddest thing is that she had to endure it for 64 years, all that because her family couldn't risk any political embarrassment. And hashtag X200B. I noticed this is more disturbing than terrifying, but I think it fits. In 1921, striking miners were bombed from US Army airplanes in the Battle of Bear Mountain 1. Al, that's interesting. Com link 2. N.Wikipedia.org link 3. www.npr.org link 4. www.wavencyclopedia.org link. Operation Mockingbird, where it was found the CIA employed about 400 top journalists in the 1960s to put out propaganda. They were caught, but it never stopped. That whole thing, where the FBI was wiretapping Martin Luther King and sent him a letter telling him to kill himself, or else they were going to start a huge news campaign about how he cheated on his wife, wasn't great. The CIA are bad, sure, but the Hoover FBI doesn't get enough press on some of the ruthless shit they were up to. COINTELPRO in general is crazy, and if you think it or something like it isn't still happening, you're deluding yourself. It's not a declassified document, but a friend of mine that served in Desert Storm told me some things. Every morning during muster, their group was given a small pill to take supposedly to protect them from the toxins the Iranians were releasing into the air. My friend thought it was odd, and he never swallowed his pill, just as some other members of their group didn't. Years go by and all of the people that he still talks to that took the pill have cancer of various types as well as a plethora of other medical issues. The ones that did not take the pill seemingly have nothing wrong with them other than normal effects of being middle-aged. Some crazy stuff, and often the military enlisted become guinea pigs for the government without their knowledge or consent. Looking at all these top comments is making me ask, are we the baddies? FISA courts almost never deny requests for warrants for surveillance, and the existence of those warrants is classified. In 2005 they had 2,000 requests, denied 0. You cannot represent yourself or appeal since its existence is classified. A 2003 congressional hearing revealed that agents who made FISA applications didn't understand the concepts or probable cause and agent of a foreign power, both requirements for FISA to apply. Even when the results of that surveillance result in charges, the government has successfully maintained that they do not need to say what the surveillance application said. In 2000 the FISC found that FBI agents has lied in at least 75 applications. Those applications were not invalidated. Of course, Bush later decided to just have the NSA do surveillance without a warrant, and when the Supreme Court found him, and that, and others, guilty of violating multiple amendments and laws, Obama signed a law pardoning them. I don't like the pig-human hybrids. The one that says birds are fake, they're surveillance drones. USA/CIA overthrew the democratically elected leaders to install puppet dictators all over the world. Wonder why Central America, South America, Africa and the Middle East are doing poorly. We destroyed their government and put crazy people in charge. Most of these governments never recovered. Not declassified but rather leaked by a man named Gary Webb, who committed suicide by shooting himself in the back of the head twice with a shotgun, wrote a book called The Dark Side, detailing how the CIA smuggled crack into inner cities to be distributed among lower class black neighborhoods. Here's a former Canadian defense minister testifying to his direct experience with UFOs in the Royal Canadian Air Force. Yao 2.B link. I watched the video. Nowhere in the video does he speak of direct experience. Execute Order 66. Hello there. Lol, the most terrifying one isn't anywhere near the top. The Snowden files. The US government mass surveillance projects. Capitalize mass because they are collecting upwards of 50 to 75% of all communication in the US. That is an incredible violation of our right to decline unwarranted search and seizure. Removed by the US government. Not so terrifying, but during the Tlatelolco student protests in Mexico, the reason shit ticked off is because of Mexican military snipers disguised as civilians fired upon the crowds. This is kinda important for me, as my Mexican grandfather refuses to believe that there is video and photo evidence and official documents that prove the military's role in the Tlatelolco massacre. The president at the time even had an interview where he admitted to it, but I don't wanna argue with my grandfather, because my dad says shit would go down, and he's old. I'm not sure how much more he can take. Operation Northwoods, essentially a plan by the US gov to pull off 9/11 during the Cold War as an excuse to go to war with Cuba. The plan included hijacking and crashing planes with US citizens on it to justify a war with Cuba. Pretty much convinced me 9/11 was an inside job. The CIA's heart attack gun. www.military.com link. The KGB had a similar device. www.cia.gov link that prompted the CIA to invent one as well. In 1975, the United States Senate Select Committee to Study Governmental Operations with Respect to Intelligence Activities, ACA, the Church Committee, looked into activities by the CIA, NSA, and FBI. There was also a White House and House of Representatives committees to look into those agencies in 1975. The heart attack gun was revealed at committee hearings. First big issue of the committee was that those agencies had free rein to do what they want. The Church Committee's investigations led to the Senate Intelligence Committee to oversee the CIA, which until then had not had any congressional oversight. The very existence of the National Security Agency wasn't revealed to the public until the Church Committee. Other revelations include NSA spying on the American public without warrants, Project Minaret and Project Shamrock. Even committee chairman Frank Church had been spied on. The CIA illegally acquired information. HistoryMatters.com link on Daniel Ellsberg, who leaked the Pentagon Papers. The CIA plotted assassinations. HistoryMatters.com link of at least 5 foreign leaders. The CIA tries working with American mobsters to have Fidel Castro killed, Operation Mongoose. The CIA drugged unknowing individuals with LSD as part of mind control experiments, Project Incultura, and destroyed documents related to the project. In the 1990s, the CIA provides flawed nuclear weapon plans to the Iranian government, Operation Merlin. The Iranians discovered and corrected the flaws, so their nuclear program was actually accelerated by the CIA. In 2014, there was the Senate Intelligence Committee report on CIA torture. The CIA routinely used brutal torture methods against suspected terrorists and lied to other parts of the US government about it. Significant amounts of people held by the CIA were totally innocent. The committee found not one instance where torture led to actionable intelligence. Torturers and those who authorized torture were not held accountable. The CIA spied on Senate committee members. www.nighttimes.com link investigating them. The full report itself was classified and accidentally destroyed by the CIA. Fairhill.com link. In 2005, the CIA destroyed video evidence of torture against detainees. Noone was punished for destroying the evidence. Operation Northwoods. It was a plan which JFK turned down to carry out a number of domestic terrorist attacks and pin them on Cuba, so we could get the American public and lawmakers in favor of an all-out assault. So, pretty much every conspiracy today. MKUltra, illegal experimenting on civilians and possible Russian spies, to test the use of drugs like LSD to see if they could help control a person's responses. It was pretty much a mind control program. They said at one point they were even able to tell a dog to walk, turn, and sit, all using a remote controller and brain implants in the dogs themselves. There's this court document that says Donald Trump raped a little girl. www.scribd.com link. Does that count? Edit. Some readers will be checking the most downvoted comments. Thank you for the visibility, Redats. Panama Papers. Which everyone forgot about already thanks to media. I may be buried here, but the CIA overthrown Iran's democratically elected government in 1953. N.m. Wikipedia.org link. We could have had a thriving democracy in the Middle East, but now we are stuck trying our hardest to find an excuse to go to war with them. I wish the US foreign policy machine didn't exist. Anything CIA. The Nth Country Experiment. Three brand new physics PhDs, none of whom had ever had access to nuclear weapons design information, nor were allowed access during the experiment, and only two of whom were working at a given time, came up with a credible design for a nuclear weapon in the 1960s, when the computational support they had access to was less than we keep in our pockets today. The takeaway is that any country that can send a few students to grad school can probably design a nuclear warhead when they want, and most likely already has. Materials and international backlash are the only things working against proliferation. There was some high school student in America that built a redneck/DIY version of a nuclear reactor for a school project, if I remember correctly. FBI came and took it or something like that. A good amount of people already know this, but the US government forgave Nazi scientists of their crimes in exchange that they work for NASA. Have you noticed how most of these are from America? Have you noticed how Reddit is an American website? The CIA and how much unchecked power they have is legit scary. If this is just the stuff we know about, think of what we don't know. So far as I know, there was a book that was written by a relatively unknown man called Chan Thomas. Correct me if I'm wrong, called The Adam and Eve Story. The book was along very similar lines to the works of Charles Hapgood and his books on Earth crust displacement. However, the only difference between these two is that The Adam and Eve Story was classified by the CIA and only recently became declassified. However, the book itself was heavily sanitized for release, leading to over 70% of the actual book to have been completely omitted from the declassified document. There's even entire pages missing from earlier chapters with seemingly no explanation as to why, and after reading it, one might reasonably come to the conclusion, so what the hell was in this, that the CIA felt they needed to completely hide this book from the masses until now, and they still won't let us see the good majority of the book either, because honestly a lot of what they left in it makes the book and its premises sound far-fetched as hell, despite the sanitized version still managing to make more sense than the works of Charles Hapgood. I fucking hate these threads. Always leave out the Israeli attack on the US Liberty, not to mention the Lavin affair. Links, sources? Come on now, don't complain if you aren't gonna fix it. So post about them, dummy. Lots of reasons to shit on the US here, but notice there aren't any other countries chiming in. Those citizens don't get to know what their government has been up to. Not sure if it was ever classified, but the Netherlands sold cocaine during WW1 to both sides of the war, prolonging the war a couple of years, because higher-ups could stuff their soldiers with cocaine and keep them going. Ask me in 2057. It's about a specific piece of military hardware. The fact that there are still a ton of nuclear missiles that run on IBMs with those flexible floppy disks is a slightly terrifying fact. www.google.com link. Honestly, it seems to be somewhat smart. With the current cyber warfare that is able to be pulled off by countries, the pre-hacking technology seems quite smart. Not really. They are reliable machines and impossible to hack, since they have no connection to the outside world. Are there good examples from outside the US? I've seen all these American ones in similar threads before. All I'm seeing here are great band names. The Rendlesham Forest Incident. A nuclear armed silo based in the UK. Top secret security clearances, and they have a UFO come and disable their missile system at the height of the Cold War and possible missile exchanges. Well documented. CIA studied remote viewing, and one target unknown to the viewer was Mars 1 million years BC. The viewer found subjects living there after a terrible tragedy that ruined the livable conditions of the planet. The subjects were trying to find a livable place. Maybe another planet in the same solar system. www.cia.gov link. Ned's Declassified School Survival Guide. The documents from United States v. Reynolds, the short version is that a B-29 crashed, and there was an official report about the cause. Families of people who died in the crash wanted the report, which may have included evidence of negligence that led to the deaths. Because the report was embarrassing, the US government refused to hand it over and claimed, falsely, that the report contained sensitive information about military secrets. They asserted what is now known as the state secrets privilege to keep facts from the affected families and from the public at large. Courts, up to the Supreme Court, accepted this argument and established the principle by precedent. Decades later, the report was declassified and there were no secrets hidden. The entire thing was just a lie all along, and the courts went along with it, and the practical result is that the government can just lie at any time about national security whenever they want to cover up evil or idiotic actions by government officials, and they always get away with it. That's why, for example, people tortured by the CIA can't sue, because our torture program is a state secret. End.wikipedia.org link. The Kennedy Declassified Documents Causally has a section about trailing Hitler's movement through Argentina and nobody fucking cares. All the good shit in AATIP is redacted, so it reads like a comic book. Prescott Bush trying to overthrow the US government and install a fascist regime with himself at the top comes to mind. Him and a bunch of rich guys got pissed they couldn't keep financially destroying the country. Wikipedia The Business Plot IDK, why I'm not able to paste a link. CIA document on how Hitler did not die after the war, but escaped to South America where he lived out the rest of his life. Source from CIA website, www.google.com link. This isn't declassified, but all information on gun deaths I've been able to find on government websites have been from 1993 to 2011. Those years saw a steady decline in gun deaths. 2012 to 2017 had a strong increase. I can't find anything on 2018/2019. I don't know what's worse though, the fact that the government is hiding the increase, or the fact that the non-government websites are ignoring that most of the deaths are suicides. Fucking aliens. They are AI-mails though. Vault.fbi.gov link. Not technically declassified, but the leaked Panama Papers revealed a global network of billionaires and politicians conspiring to launder money and evade taxes. The surprisingly terrifying part is that by and large they got away with it. I think in the US one person has been indicted. 1. Like and subscribe for good luck, you handsome gentlemen.